There's something I just wanted to talk about, and it's been on my mind for quite a while, and God has put it on my heart to talk about it, and I just feel like I need to share. So, as many of you know, watched my channel for a long time, I am a Christian. If that's just come to a shock to you now, then, yay, I'm Christian, I believe in God, I follow Jesus, but I just, sorry, I'm just trying to collect my thoughts. I just want to talk about a little bit about my life before Jesus and my life now. Life before Jesus, I was a very negative person. Now there's a lot of details I can go into, but I'm going to try to keep this as concise as possible. I was so negative in my teens and mostly my 20s. I was a very, very angsty person. I was so negative that I hated myself and I just had negative thoughts about everything. And anything that was positive or good, I was very cynical about and very negative toward it, and I would turn those things around to find the negativity in the situation or just project my negativity onto that situation. Some of this might be hard to hear if you've had some of these feelings or whatever, but I'm just admitting stuff. It got to the point where, like, I hated myself so much that it was almost like, you know, I was depressed, but at the point where I wasn't, like, gloomy depressed. I mean, at times I was, but it was more like denial depressed, if that makes any sense. Like, I thought, you know, life sucked, and I sucked, and the world sucked, and everybody else in the world sucked, but instead of, like, crawling in my bed and staying there and hating the world, I just chose to criticize it and gripe and complain and laugh at it and pretend like it was so funny, you know? And, you know, I found a friend who did the same thing and we kind of just fed off each other. And when I was younger, I didn't understand the term misery loves company. And now I do. And it's more like misery breeds. Company breeds misery. That's what it is, actually. So it was a really unhealthy thing. And at the time, we felt like we were good friends and there for each other, but it ended up in a toxic relationship anyway. So it got to the point where, of course, I did have some suicidal thoughts at times. I got so mad and did things to hurt myself. Not like major cutting like some people do, because it was more like the attempt to hurt myself, and I was never really successful, praise God. A couple times I hurt myself, but it's more of the idea of wanting to, and I just felt like that I deserved it. I deserved to be punished all the time. And I believed in God during all this time. I just didn't really know Jesus. And I just felt like I was a waste of time and God wouldn't care. You know, why should he care about me? So I just continued to punish myself and hate myself. I got to the point where I said one time that why didn't I abort myself when I was in the womb? Isn't that a terrible thing to say? But that was like one of the things I said when I was like joking, and yet that was kind of at one of my low points. I couldn't be happy for anybody because my life sucked and I didn't like where I was going with it, so why should I be happy for anybody else? And I felt like if people had happy lives or good things going on it, that, you know, that's them, and that kind of stuff is never going to happen to me. It's not even in the cards. Nothing. Nothing at all good will ever happen to me. I truly, truly, truly believe that. I also have another video in my really old videos talking about my testimony. If you want to hear more details on how I came to be curious about Christianity and came to know Jesus, but right now I'm just talking about my life before and after. Now, after Jesus, I struggled a lot still with my self-esteem. I struggled a lot with changing things, but I felt Jesus changing me. I felt him stirring up something inside of me, and it helped me to grow and die to those old feelings. I still get them once in a while, you know, like small inklings, but it's not nowhere near anything like it was. Like, I feel like I have worth now as a person. I feel like I have love, and I know that God loves me. I know that I'm important to him, and I know that he's going to use me for something. And I know that he has delivered me many times. He's created a future for me. I'm living my future now that I didn't think I would. And he's going to continue to create a good future for me. And I have peace and confidence in that now, because before it was just nothing. It was just like a black hole. My favorite word used to be shame spiral. I always said I was stuck in a shame spiral. I think I heard that from a movie somewhere, but just, it was like that. Like, I was constantly in a black hole, or like a tornado or a maelstrom, just spinning around. And now it's like, I get little jabs and pangs of old feelings, but then I remember that God is way bigger than anything I could ever feel. And then pray, take some deep breaths, try to center myself, and I know he's going to help me through it. Do things take me over, and do I still have anxiety? Yes. But I'm trying to work on that this year, especially, just to get through some of these feelings, because at times I feel like they're too big, you know, like they're just, the anxiety is just too big, and I can't even give it over, or like, it's not going to go away fast enough. And I admit that those are the times that I'm probably just not trusting enough, but I feel like I am, so it's a constant. What I'm trying to say is, it's not completely black and white, you know, from my past to now. It is a big change now as compared to my past. But I still have little struggles, but these struggles are so small compared to the way they used to be. I feel so much better. Like, I guess it is a pretty big change, which is good, because I always felt like I was missing something, and I felt like I was trying to fill voids, you know, and always look for the next new thing that I can enjoy or get into, or the next thing I can just pour my negativity into or whatever. And now it's like, I do get those feelings again, you know, where I'm like, yeah, what's next, you know, but it's more like, I have something to look forward to in the future. And every day I have life to look forward to with my family and God, and just knowing that I know how the story ends. Even in the midst of chaos in this world, I know that God is going to take care of me and my family and the rest of, you know, whoever believes in him. He's going to help us through this. And I trust that, and I'm really excited for when he comes back. And yeah, anyway, I just wanted to share that. I feel like this video went somewhere different than I expected it to. I felt like it it was going to be more, what's the word? Not really rehearsed, but I felt like it was going to be more like points. This, 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 and then this. But I just wanted to speak from the heart. And you don't have to have fancy equipment. You don't have to have fancy lighting. You don't have to have professionalism to make a video to just say what you're feeling. And I got that advice from a wonderful person who's no longer with us. The Celtic Goth. We miss you. He always made me feel good. And I think that's really important too. Like when I was in my friendship of negativity and toxicity, it's like we didn't build each other up. We helped tear each other down and we encouraged self-pity. And I feel like there's too much of that, especially with young people. And I feel like we need to support each other and build each other up. If one person's feeling down, build them up. Find something that they're doing that you really enjoy or something you like about them and just tell them and help them to feel good inside. Help them to just feel more confident and at peace and bring them out of these feelings that they have of inadequacy and fear. Because when somebody gives you a compliment or somebody, you know, tells you, hey, it's okay, you're doing just fine, you know, it can lift a weight off your shoulders and it can make you feel so much better. Because otherwise you get into that shame spiral and just spiral down and start all this bad self-talk and the tape recorder starts in your mind. But when you have somebody there to help you with that, it's just an amazing feeling. So thank you to those who have done that for me, you know, in life and the past and the present and the future. And those of you who are always commenting such sweet comments, and I love talking to you guys in the comments. I'm just very grateful for you all. Thank you. Love you. God loves you.